Dear friends, we love our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam so adorably, isn't it? He was born in the holy city of Mecca. He also lived in Medina. Hundreds of places in these two cities are bearing the witness of our beloved Prophet. Had I the wings of a bird, I would have flown there to see them with my own eyes. But it's not impossible. What we need is just a wish. Right at this moment, we shall have a virtual travel to some of those reminiscing places of him. So friends, let's hang out with Kids Creation TV. The city of Mecca. Mecca is known to be the holiest site in Islam. It is the provincial capital of Hijaz of Saudi Arabia. It is this city where our beloved Prophet was born in and where the first revelation of the Holy Quran took place. Here stands the Holy Kaaba, facing who the Muslims of the world pray five times a day. The paths and trails of this city still proclaim the grace of having Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Cave of Hira. The Cave of Mount Hira is one of the most beloved reminiscing places of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Mecca. It is situated 3 miles north of Masjid al-Haram. In his youth, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to sit in meditation in this cave for long hours. It is that place which is marked as the first place of revelation of the Holy Quran. So, this mountain and this cave occupy a special place into the deep of the hearts of the Muslims. The other name of this mountain is Jabal e-Nur, or the Mountain of Light. Medina Munawwarah. Medina is the second holiest site in Islam. Historically, it is an important city because our beloved Prophet lived here after he had migrated from Mecca. In 622 AD, with the instruction of Allah, he migrated here with his close associate Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. The Holy Rauda of the Prophet is situated in this city. In 2021, the World Health Organization declared Medina as the most healthy and livable city in the world. A number of ancient mosques with historical values are located in Medina. Masjid an-Nabawi, the most beloved institution to the Muslim Ummah, is situated here. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam built this mosque after he had migrated here, and he personally took part in its construction work. At present, this mosque has been beautifully decorated with modern architecture, keeping the old one intact. Battlegrounds. In order to establish Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to go for war a number of times against the enemies. He physically took part in 27 battles. The others were conducted under his command and dictation. But none of those wars were meant for expanding territory or acquiring others' belonging. What we call war booty. All of them were imposed on him. The work of the Mujahideen was only resisting the enemies. Among many, the grounds of Badr, Uhud, and Khandaq are the most familiar to us. Let's have a trip to those. Badr Ground. Badr is the first battleground of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It took place on 17 Ramadan 624 AD. This ground is located 80 miles southwest of Medina. In this battle, Allah gave victory to only 313 Muslims over 1,000 of Quraysh enemies. This battle was a clear indication of the fact that victory comes from Allah. Uhud Ground. The open valley near the mountain of Uhud is called Uhud Ground. In this battle, the Muslims suffered a sad defeat to the Quraysh due to some of their mistakes. None other than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was injured in it. 73 Mujahideen were martyred and 23 enemy soldiers were killed in this battle. The place where a tooth of the Prophet was knocked down has been marked for years. Khandaq Ground. The Arabic term Khandaq stands for bunker or trench. It is quite a modern war tactic. In order to provide a safeguard to Medina, the Muslims maneuvered deep trenches around the city. This venture took almost a week and diligent work from them. On 21st March 627 AD, the combined military force of the Quraysh, the Bedouin, and the Yahud approached to Medina. They led an army of 3,000 soldiers against 1,600 Muslims. They kept Medina surrounded for 27 days, but failed to cross its trenches. Dear friends, we have just taken a glimpse at some of those reminiscing places of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from many. These are the gems of our history. We do pray to Allah that He might give us the opportunity to visit those places at least once in life. Ameen.